Welcome back, Beowulf Nation. It's on Beowulf. Back at it with Jet Ski Yamaha GP 1800R SBH Supercharged Jet Ski Video.
Man, why is there so many waves in here and there's nothing here? I mean, that's pretty wild of why there's...
So right now there's a red flag advisory. I think I've heard it before, but I don't recall ever riding with pre-warned about a red, even a red flag advisory where I'm at. And I figured it's in the ocean, but who knows what's going on with that. But it's really windy out, but not crazy. I wouldn't say it's the windiest. It's about, let's see how hot it is. 76 degrees. It was about 80 right before I got in. And it doesn't feel like 76. It feels cooler because as soon as the breeze comes in, you can feel the temperature drop even though it's hot out. It's kind of weird. But anyways, if you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button. Existing subscribers, hit the bell notification. Also, too, hit the like button. Besides that, check out my Amazon store, amazon.com/shop/IamBeowulf. Check out the I Am Beowulf merch at IamBeowulf.com. So a little quick story before we head out and let it rip out here in Intercoastal Waterway in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Now you guys have seen some past videos why issues with the new 2021 Yamaha GP 1800R. Besides why I canceled my orders, there's been a bunch of videos. Well, breaking news off the press. May I keep the person's name, not saying who it is. Just, I mean, it's his decision to go public telling about stuff, but I snapshot it and may I just keep... I'll keep my mouth shut who it is, just so I don't want anybody to get in trouble, because he is paid, or he is a factory racer for Yamaha, which I'll go through a whole nother video. He basically in one post said how the new Superjet 2021 Superjet is junk and a waste of money, and then posted you know, a lot of people were thinking the new 2021s of all these changes they thought were better, and if you've seen the one guy who had tons of issues where his stop start button, he pulled the lanyard out and the thing would keep on going. He had a bunch of issues besides that, like a whole list of stuff. The ski stopped running. I mean, just crazy stuff. But anyways, this racer had a race over the weekend, and within, I think he just posted within 3 hours, the supercharged clutch went out on those. All the teeth were completely taken out, and you can see it in this picture that I took a snapshot of, that which I thought was totally crazy. I thought it's crazy he showed it. I'm not trying to tell people not to buy the new Yamahas. It's the same with the new Sea-Doos, where they're claiming they somehow fixed the carbon seal. The only way to fix it is to not have a carbon seal at all. To completely redesign, not to put a band-aid. I mean, it's not to knock every brand, but just because they said they fixed something, do you think it really is done? And that's relating to all brands, if it's Kawasaki, Yamaha, or Sea-Doo. Just because they said something, so what? Their goal is to make money from you buying their stuff. So why would they be like, well, we fixed it, but we're not sure if we got fixed. Their goal is to take your money. The same as some of these small-time shops that people think are really big, trying to up the power on these jet skis. And the more stuff you do, the more issues you're going to have. And they don't care, because you got to keep on coming back or you're buying stuff. So that's their goal. The same as when you watch my videos, I'm never full throttle. I'm probably the most, not the whole time, but maybe 80% throttle. A little smidge of where it's full throttle, but not where I'm riding the whole entire time. I would highly recommend not riding on full throttle all the time if you have a supercharged jet ski. And even if you had a naturally aspirated, I mean, it's your choice of what you want to do. But I think when it's supercharged, there's just no point of full throttling, especially on the weights. You don't want to have the RPMs fly up when you're jumping weights. You just got to be really throttle control. A lot of all these supercharged jet skis, it's really smart to have a super or a blow off valve. But in this case, I'm not sure if this one where the clutch went out within 3 hours, that there was a blow off valve. It's racing, so I wouldn't doubt that you could change it. But some of these series that you can only mod certain things. But that's just something to think about, even though there's conditions it were as racing. I just figured to bring that knowledge. I'm not telling you to sell if you got the new 2021. I mean, I'm lucky I got almost, we're gonna hit 60 hours in this video, and I've had no supercharged clutch issue. But I'm really like, I have, you see, I go out and let it rip, but I'm not out to beat the snot out of the ski. I don't wanna be stranded somewhere And especially with the shortage of everything going on, it's not just jet ski parts. There's a lot of shortage of stuff. I had to upgrade from an L5 plugs for my crypto mining to an L6 plug with my 240 volts. And electricians that were installing this, upgrading for me, went out to buy the last two L6 plugs in my county. That's how shortage of stuff is. They had to go driving around for like a couple hours trying to find some, and then they got the last two in my county. So I'm just, everything, there's a shortage. So your goal is not to have something, otherwise you're gonna have a big giant paperweight of your ski not being fixed. But hey, I'm not telling you guys what to do. Enough chitty chatter. Yo, Babel, roll the beat.